Music Travels with Daniel Edwards.
You're listening to Music Travels here on Radio Broccoli. My name's Daniel Edward. We're going to move on to our first song for this show proper, and it's going to be from Brazil. This has been recommended to me by my friend Barbara, who I met whilst I was working on a cruise ship. She was working as a waitress there, but she's now working in a hotel in Dubai. And her Facebook stream is full of incredible photos of all the different places that she goes and visits on her work and travels as well. Brazil is the largest country in South America. Speaks Portuguese as its language because it was ruled by Portugal from 1500 to 1822, which makes me think that actually we should be calling Portuguese Brazilian, given that more people speak Portuguese in Brazil than they actually do in Portugal. Well, I'll let you think about this little trivia question whilst I play Aguas de Março, which means Waters of March, by Tom Jobim and Elis Regina. What is the capital city of Brazil? Ah, that's Aguas de Março, Waters of March, by Tom Jobim and Elis Regina. That's been recorded more than 60 times since it was originally composed by Jobim in 1972. And something you may have picked up from listening to it is it doesn't actually tell a story. It melodically and lyrically, though we may not understand the Portuguese itself, represents a torrent of water flowing from the gutters in Rio de Janeiro in March, which is that city's rainiest month, and that was the inspiration for the song. Before I played the song, I asked you what was the capital city of Brazil. Lots of people think that it is Rio de Janeiro. It is not. The capital city of Brazil is Brasilia. We're going to move across to the home of over 30 UNESCO World Heritage Sites next. It is officially called the United Mexican States. We know it as Mexico. It has 33 states and Mexico City, and is also the home of my friend Chrissy, who I met also on a cruise ship. She was a passenger, though. It was in February of 2015, and it was just out of the main winter season. We were cruising from Texas, and the majority of passengers, you may know this if you've ever been on a cruise, were rather old. They were certainly mainly retirees, probably mostly over the age of 85, mainly from Houston, just because of where we were cruising. And so I met Chrissy and her friend Sandra, who were on the lookout for other younger people on board, and they met one. It wasn't me, and Chrissy is now marrying him next May, so I take a little bit of credit for introducing them, though it was not with the explicit aim of marrying them off. Her song choice is a brilliant one for the occasion, though, because she suggested Las Mañanitas. She's specifically wanted Alejandro Fernandez's version of it, and this is a traditional Mexican birthday song. The first line meaning, this is the morning song King David used to sing. Today, being the day of your saint, we sing it to you. Las Mañanitas, Alejandro Fernandez version there. Thank you very much to my friend Chrissy from Mexico for suggesting that one. We're now going to go across to Alberto's suggestions. Now, Alberto comes from Peru, which is the second largest section of the Amazon rainforest after Brazil. In fact, the Amazon covers 60% of the country, which is also that part of the Amazon rainforest is home to the most bird species in the world. But Alberto couldn't think of any music that came from Peru. So Alberto's suggestions come from other places in the Spanish-speaking world. He's got two requests for us. The first is going to come from Spain, the second from Mexico. So the first request is called La Flaca. It's by Jarebe de Palo, which is a band. It was initially a complete and utter flop when it was released in 1996, but then, for some reason, rocketed to El Número Uno in the Spanish albums chart after featuring in a TV advert. So that's the power of advertising for you. And then if you want to get an idea of Alberto's personality, then all you have to do is listen to song number two, which is a song from Mexico called La Ingrata, and it just makes me chuckle and laugh, which is exactly what Alberto does too. So first up, we have La Flaca by Jarebe de Palo. Thank you. Langrata Cafe Cacva is the artist there, and that was suggested by my friend Alberto from Peru. That song won the International Viewer's Choice Award for MTV Latin America, so he's not the only one who likes it. It puts a massive smile on my face, and I can't think of any friend better to play after Alberto than a song recommended by Hillary. If there's one person in this list who's bubbling over with personality, it's got to be Hillary. She went to Shanghai with some friends in 2014, and this is the song that she recommended from that trip. She said anytime she hears it, it takes her back, and they played it in temples, and they played it in shops, and they just played it absolutely everywhere. When you hear the song, you'll realise that it's the most bizarre song to be played in a temple. And to be honest, it's a pretty strange song to be played in a few places. But she must have really liked it over there. She's headed back. She's now gone to Hong Kong. She was in Shanghai. She's gone over for a six-month work secondment. So good luck to her for that one. China is one of the, as we know, largest countries in the world. It has, though, the largest population in the world. 1.3 billion people live in China, and it borders 14 other countries. At the summit of Mount Everest marks the border between China and Nepal, which is something which I found out whilst looking into China when Hillary said that she was going back over there for work. I thought I'll find out a little bit more about that fine place. And the song that she has chosen is by a band called Chopsticks Brothers. If you're brave and you have access to YouTube, I recommend at some point having a look for the music video of this song called Little Apple. It is the most strange music video you will ever see. I don't know what they were on when they were making this music video, but it was something strong. But I'll just tell you, the chorus means, "You're my little, little apple. I can't love you more. Your little red face warms my heart. You're the fire that lights my life." So as weird as the music video is, it is a nice message. Little Apple by the Chopsticks Brothers. It is a fun song. That was suggested by Hillary, who is currently in Hong Kong for 6 months. So I hope she's having fun over there. And of course, we are having a great bonanza of fun here at Radio Broccoli to celebrate our 50th anniversary of being London's longest running hospital radio station. So we hope that we are picking your time up here in the hospital, helping you smile a little bit whilst you're recovering. And the next song is a traditional Dutch song to say happy birthday. It's Lang Zal Ze Leven. Born in the USA, Bruce Springsteen here on Radio Broccoli, celebrating our 50th birthday. And if you'd like to tweet us a birthday message, use the hashtag Broccoli50. It'd be great to hear from you, and we hope you are getting better soon as well. Before that, we heard Lang Zal Ze Leven, which is a traditional happy birthday song from the Netherlands. Sounded a little bit like a children's nursery song, but I suppose happy birthday in English sounds pretty much the same. So who are we to judge? We're going to move to Italy next, my favourite of the European continental countries. And did you know that Italy has two independent states within it? I think most people know about Vatican City, but there is, in fact, another one, and it goes by the name of San Marino, which I didn't know even existed. So that is something that I learned, finding out about Italy. Two independent states. And, of course, we all know about Italy's fabulous design. Their car designs perhaps put the rest of us to shame. Ferrari, Lamborghini, Alfa Romeo, Maserati. They've got them all. And the song that Virginia has chosen for Music Travels this week is a very appropriate song, because it's all about travelling, both in the literal and metaphorical sense. It's a song by Ligabue. It's called Il Centro del Mondo, meaning the centre of the world, which is a rocky love song about travelling. And Virginia likes Ligabue so much that she is in fact going to see him in concert in Milan this very week. Ligabue's Il Centro del Mondo on Radio Broccoli, suggested by Virginia, who is going to see him in concert next week. Well, we've got a huge celebration here at Radio Broccoli, celebrating our 50th birthday. And coming up at 3 o'clock after me is Pick and Mix with Karina. So stay tuned for that. That's going to be a lot of chatter, a lot of music and a lot of fun. So that's coming up next. And then at 4 o'clock, you've got Naomi with The Remedy, which is a look at music therapy from different cultures and religions, with some guest interviews as well. And Emma brings us the Alpha Sessions with live music from Helena and Martin Buchanan in this anniversary special of her show coming up later on today. We're going to move across to Greece next. My parents have just got back from a little holiday in Greece, and I met a boy called Nikos, who's from Greece, when I was working in Bristol as the manager of a summer school there. It was one of those English language learning summer schools, and I have to say that Nikos probably didn't need the English learning. His English was probably better than mine was already. But he suggested a really interesting piece for us. It's got some real story to it. I'll tell you, the name of the song is The Seven Dwarves on SS Serenia. And it's by a musician called Thanos Mikroutsikos, which I hope I said sort of accurately. But actually, the words are not Thanos's himself. They are belonging to Nikos Kavadias, who was a Greek sailor, poet, and writer. Which made me think, if you're familiar with the musical Cats by Andrew Lloyd Webber, who he took the old poems of Eliot, when this, I think, is a very similar idea. Nikos Kavadias, who was the poet-writer, he was born in 1910 in Russia, but two Greek parents, and they ended up moving back to Greece. And when he died in 75, he was living in Athens in Greece. But he used his travels as a sailor as a metaphor for the escape of normal people outside the boundaries of reality. And this is one of his stories, which is a fantastical tale of a ship serviced by seven dwarves, and each dwarf is tasked with a specific task that they have to fulfill on board the ship. So enjoy the musical piano accompaniment at the beginning, and then the words of Nikos Kavadias, the Greek sailor, poet, and writer. What a passionately sung song about seven dwarves on the SS Serenia. That's Thanos Mikroutsikos doing the music there for the words of Nikos Kavadias, the Greek sailor and poet. Thank you very much to Nikos from Greece for suggesting that song. We're moving across now to Spain, the home of tapas and paella. It's Ainara's home as well, and she has suggested a song by an artist called Rosamund. The song is Saltan Chispas. And the last time that Ainara gave me some Spanish music to play was when we were working together on the cruise ships, and we were both part of the entertainment team. And we were doing dance lessons as part of the entertainment. And she always used to do a Latin line dance class because she was Spanish and she knew the moves and she could do the hip movements. And she wouldn't, you know, stiffen up like a plank of wood like a little English boy like me would. And so I said, no, I'll learn it and I'll cover it for you. And so we stayed up so late in the office learning these dance moves. And so she lent me her iPod to go and do this dance class, and I wasn't very confident about the dance moves, to be honest. So what I did, and I thought this was a clever idea, I printed out the choreography for myself and I laminated it so that I would have it up by the pool where I was doing the dance lesson on the pool dance deck. Unfortunately, if you've ever been on a cruise, you may realise that when a ship is moving in one direction at, say, 20 miles an hour, there is a wind speed that goes in the opposite direction. So it was quite windy out on the pool deck, and my beautifully laminated piece of paper blew away. It was the worst dance lesson I have ever taken because I didn't know the music, nor did I know the moves. Anyway, this song by Rosalind, Saltan Chispas, is recommended by Ainara.
Salta. saltan chispas mis dedos contra el papel. Lo confieso, no puedo disimular. Saltan chispas. Saltan chispas. Saltan chispas. Saltan chispas.
Saltan chispas, Rosalén. Thank you very much to Ainara for suggesting that one. And on to the final song for this show, Music Travels. But of course, stay tuned for our next one, Pick a Mix with Karina. It's from Denmark. Lisette is the friend who suggested it, and she is very elegant. So you might be surprised to hear that the song she has suggested by the Danish band Aqua, who did Barbie Girl, is Dr. Jones. Thanks very much for listening. Stay tuned to Radio Broccoli. Pick a Mix coming up next.